Hey guys, it's Ellie. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. So I've seen maybe one video of doing your makeup with your non-dominant hand, and I thought it was so clever because I can't write with my non-dominant hand like most humans. And so if I can't write with my non-dominant hand, I wonder how it would look doing your makeup with your non-dominant hand. I am left-handed, so I'm going to be doing my whole face of makeup with my right hand. So if you guys want to see me do my makeup with my non-dominant hand, keep on watching. So usually for primer, I like to use a moisturizer only because when I use a moisturizer, I have more of a dewy finish to my makeup. So I'm going to be using my Cetaphil moisturizer and just put it on like that. Okay. It shouldn't be too hard, but it doesn't feel right because I always use my left hand. So this feels like so weird. I always wonder how you become left or right-handed. When you're younger and you're like starting to learn how to write and everything, you just pick up a pencil with like one of your hands and then boom, you're right-handed, or boom, you're left-handed. Like how does that work? Okay, that wasn't too hard. Let's move on to foundation. So I'm just going to be using the L'Oreal Infallible Wear Foundation, and I'm going to put some on my face. Like that. Okay, I'm gonna take this flat brush and I'm going to start blending it. This does not feel right. It doesn't feel right, like, at all. Like, I don't have as much control if I'm just, like, doing that. It's because I'm not used to using my right hand, so. Okay, and then my forehead. Ooh, this feels so weird. I think that's the best it'll be. Next, I'm going in with my Tarte Shape Tape, and I'm going to grab some of this. I'm going to put on my eyes. Little bit right here. Okay, and blend it out with my brush. Also, I used to have lights like, Lexi. I used to have lights like right there to like illuminate the background kind of. And then I brought out my Christmas tree right there. I have a white little Christmas tree, and those lights burned out last year, I think. So I used the lights that I normally had, and I put it on the white Christmas tree, getting a little festive. So it looks pretty good. I think the only thing is just like blending. That's all. If I can get that, then I'm good. Okay, so next I'm going to take this CoverGirl foundation. This is in a darker shade than I am. This is in the shade 870. Let me get my brushes out. Okay, so what I like to do is I like to take a little bit on the back of my hand, just like that much, because I don't need a whole lot. And then I will take this flat brush and grab a little. Oh, what did I just do? I did that with my left hand. Okay, and then I will use this to contour my face. Okay, I put it on my right hand, so I'll just grab it with my left and then put it on with my right. Like that. Okay, there we go. On my forehead. No, okay, that did not work. Okay, that looks a little crazy. Okay, and then I'm just going to blend it in with that same brush. Oh. Okay. I just have to be very careful where I'm putting the brush. This is so hard. Literally the whole video I'm just gonna be like saying how difficult this is, but I can always fix it. Oh, this hurts my right hand. Ow! Okay, and then my forehead. Okay, then the right cheekbone. This is, my right hand hurts. I'm like,
I can't move my head.
Next, I'm gonna be taking more of this, and I'm going to take a small little defined brush, and I'm going to take some of this. Oh my goodness. My hand's like, okay, and I'm going to use this to kind of make some small little fake freckles. I've been doing this recently where I take a cream bronzer or this dark foundation that I will use as a liquid bronzer and make little freckles. And I really like how it looks because It looks very natural, and I can blend it out much easier than like a brow pencil or something. So I just put them everywhere, and then I'm going to use my finger and kind of just like tap it. And because it's a foundation, it blends super easy. So the more I tap, the more it'll blend into my skin. And then when I like the size or shade of the freckle, I will just stop tapping it and then leave it there. It looks nice and cute. So now I have some freckles, and I will put some up here, and I can add freckles around my blemishes to make them look more like freckles. Now that we have some freckles going on, I'm going to take my Coty Airspun powder. This is in the shade Translucent with Extra Coverage. And I'm going to take this with a dry sponge. I'm just going to press that in like that and bake underneath my eyes like that. It's not too hard, actually. Yeah, I've kind of gotten used to it slightly. Okay, and then that did not turn out very good. That's good enough. Okay. Okay, so next for blush, I'm going to be taking the Tarte blush in the shade Party. And I'm going to be just applying that. This is so broken. There's like barely any left. But it's such a pretty shade. So I'm going to be taking this Sonia Kashuk. Oh, I don't know. And I'm going to be taking this blush. Applying it to my cheeks. I feel like I'm doing makeup for the first time and I have like no idea how to use anything. Okay, that's not too bad. I have a little bit on my nose. And then I'll use the same brush to kind of dust away all the powder. Cause I don't really bake. I just use a beauty blender to like press in the powder. If that makes any sense. Ow. That was my eye. Kenny, what are you doing? She looks kind of spooky. Next, I'm going to take the Wet n Wild highlighter. This is in the shade Precious Petals. And I'm going to be taking my highlighter brush. Ah, this is so broken. Take in a little bit. Oh, this is probably like the hardest one. I don't know how to control my hand. Do the same thing on the other side. Okay, it's not too bad actually. And some on my nose. I'm just kind of putting it everywhere. Okay, there we go. Why does my base makeup look so good? Wow. Okay, so for brows, I'm just going to keep it simple and use the Anastasia Dip Brow Gel. This is in the shade Medium Brown. Just going to take a little bit. Oh, goodness. And then, there we go. Then I'm going to brush the hairs up like that. And then the same thing on the other side. Oh, this is even harder like this. So now that we have the brows done, I'm going to use the Rimmel Stay Matte Concealer. And I'm going to prime my eyelids for eyeshadow. I'm just going to be taking a little bit of this. And then I'm just going to blend that out with my finger. And I kind of want to do a colorful look just to really push me. Because, I mean, I don't really like doing neutral looks anyways. So, let's see what palette I'm going to use. Okay, so I think I'm going to go in with the BH Cosmetics Zodiac palette. This is what the palette looks like. It has some very pretty mattes in this circle, and then a bunch of shimmers out here, and then this pearl white. I really like to use this for highlighter because it's gorgeous. Let's get to the eyeshadow. So I will zoom you guys in so we can do the eyeshadow. I remember the lot. I don't think I've ever actually like zoomed in on my face to do like eyeshadow or anything. So, kind of exciting. I think I might want to do like a purple look. I've already done one like very recently. But I might do it again. Okay, this might turn out really bad. So, each one is a horoscope sign. One is a matte shade and one is a shimmer shade. So, this is the matte Gemini. So, this is what it looks like on the brush. So, oh, it's already creasing. So, what am I even gonna do? We'll just see. So, I'm going to take the shade and I'm going to start packing it in the inner part of my eye. Just like this. This is so hard. Trying to go in circular motions. I'm gonna be stopping like midway in my eye, like right here. I'm just going to try to build this up. Okay, that's not even that bad. And then I'm gonna do the other side. Whenever I do my eyeshadow, I always do each step on each eye, like at a time, just so I don't like forget a step. Cause I know some people, they like to do one eye first and then they'll copy it on the other eye. I can't do that. Like I actually can't, cause I'll like forget a step and then I'll look and then they look different. I'm like, what am I forgetting? And then I realize that I missed a whole step. So I just like to do the same step on each side. Okay, this looks kind of good. Looks kind of good. Okay, so now I'm going to take the matte purple shade Cancer and I'm going to deepen up the crease right here. Like this. Okay, so next I'm going to take this fluffy brush from Real Techniques and I'm going to start like buffing out the edge just a little bit. Okay, so next I'm going to take the L'Oreal concealer in the shade Eggshell. This is a super, super light. And yes, I'm attempting to do a cut crease with my right hand. Just gonna take it on this flat brush. Ew, why is there like a hair on it? So I'm just going to, actually, should I do my left first? I'm like, my arm's like all the way over here. So I'm just going to start by doing that. It was like two little bumps, but I'm not gonna worry about that too much because I feel like if I try to fix it, it's just gonna ruin everything else. So we have that. That looks pretty good actually. I'm gonna take more concealer and I'm going to do the other crease. This might be a little easier just because it's on my right side. And that turned out really good. Okay, and then I'm just going to start like patting this. So there's no streaks in the concealer. Okay, that looks decent. I'm just gonna take my finger and I'm going to pat the outside like this so that it's like, so like the cut crease kind of stops there. I've seen this look around like a few times. So I'm going to try to like kind of create a thing where it's like a cut crease that only is right here in the inner part and then do a wing right here. And for the wing, I think I'm going to use a blue. So I'm gonna use the shimmer shade Aries, which is a blue. It's really pretty. And I'm going to try to do a wing with this. Okay, then I'm going to be filling that in with the same shade. Okay, that wing is not pointed and it doesn't look that good either, but it's okay. Okay, so I just finished the right wing. It's not that good, but I'm going to leave it. And then I started my left one, and so I'm just going to keep my eye open and bring it over like this, like that, and then start filling it in with that same shade. Okay, that doesn't look bad, actually. That looks kind of good. So next, I'm going to try something. I don't know if it'll look good or not. What I think I'm going to try and do is use that and kind of, like, underline my brow. Like a little glitter line. So I'm going to be taking that same brush that I used for the freckles. And I'm going to underline my eyebrow. Okay, it doesn't look horrible. In the front, it kind of looks bad. But okay, that left one looks definitely way worse. The arch of it doesn't look bad. So then I'm going to be taking that same little brush and I'm going to be taking the Gemini purple and putting it underneath my eye. Okay, just like that. So normally I would cut the cameras.
Cut the cameras.
Okay, so I'm going to be taking some mascara and putting it on and applying it to my lashes. The camera really just decided to fall forward. I don't know if I want to add lashes or not. So now the only thing that is left is the lips. Okay, so I'm just going to be taking this liquid lipstick and I'm going to be applying it to my lips. Okay, it doesn't look good, but it's not bad. So, you know, I'm okay with that. And then I'm just going to be taking some nude lip gloss and applying it to my lips. A quick spritz of setting spray, and then this will be completing the full face of makeup using my non-dominant hand makeup challenge, all complete. Look of me using my non-dominant hand, or my right hand, look all complete. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to like this video, comment down below anything you guys want to see from me next, and subscribe to my channel for more videos. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you in the next video. Bye guys.